really had your character defining moments in that year. I just mean it's pretty tight, man. Karma? That's right, Manfred von Karma. He's the best prosecutor there is. He hasn't lost a case in his 40-year career. He is a god of prosecution, right? A god! Not a single case? He'll do anything to get a guilty verdict. Anything. Sounds like someone else I know, Edgeworth. You don't understand. I mean, he'll really do anything. Manfred von Karma is a man to be feared. That's quite a claim coming from someone who forges evidence. He taught me what it truly means to be He taught me what it really means to prosecute. What? Just picture a prosecutor as vicious as me, multiplied by a factor of 10. Ah! So, was he your teacher then, Mr. Edgeworth? Something like that. And now he's trying to get you found guilty? What a creep! Oh, wait. Maybe he's planning on losing on purpose to help you out. Not a chance. He hasn't lost once in 40 years. 40 years! He's as ruthless as me, times 20. That's pretty ruthless. Like I said, he's a god among prosecutors. I guess it's something like Mia was to me. Speaking of Mia, Maya? Huh? We could really be using Mia's help right now, don't you think? Oh! I can't. Sorry. I tried, I really tried, but I can't reach.
You couldn't reach?
I think it's because I haven't been training. My powers are weak again. Oh man, what bad timing. I'm really sorry. I'll try my best.
I hope so.
What are you whispering about?
Oh, it's nothing. Well, it's time. Let's head in.
Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Miles Edgeworth.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Mr. von Karma, have you decided on your voice yet?
Fool. You seriously think that I would stand here were I not completely prepared?
Oh, that's... Wait, I'm pretty sure you don't come from that area of Europe.
Silence!
That's completely the wrong prosecutor. What's going on? My apologies! He's even got the judge!
What has he got the judge? Scared? I hope so.
Very well, your opening statement, please.
Decisive evidence. A decisive witness. What else could possibly be required?
Nothing, of course. That should be fine. The prosecution may call its first witness.
What's with this guy? Is he royalty or something?
How am I supposed to fight against this?
I call the detective in charge of this case, Detective Dick Gumshoe.
Okay, Gumshoe's first. Let's see how this goes.
Describe the incident.
Now! Yes, sir!
Detective Gumshoe looks nervous.
Please take a look at the map. The murder happened late Christmas Eve around midnight. There was one boat in the very middle of the lake. There were two men on the boat. Now, there happened to be a woman camping here on the edge of the lake. At 12:10, she heard two pistol shots. Then, the boat started to move. It went towards the boat rental shop.
Testify to the court about your arrest. Now!
Wait, Mr. von Karma?
Yes?
Actually, I'm the one that's supposed to be handling these proceedings.
Wrong. There is only one thing you need to do here. You will slam down your gavel and say the word guilty. That is your role.
Yes, of course, you're quite right.
No, he's not!
A man called into the station around 30 minutes after midnight. We headed to the scene of the crime as fast as we could. That's where we found Mr. Edgeworth. No, I didn't suspect him of anything at all. But the next morning, a body was found in the lake. So, we had to arrest Mr. Edgeworth. I see. Very well. Begin your cross-examination, attorney. Now. You received a call from a man? Yep. But you said there was a woman camping there. She was the one who heard the two gunshots, right? That's a terrifying objection. That's why I'm not going to do that voice. The woman and the man who called in the report are two different people, obviously. Different people? There were two witnesses. Ugh. Their testimonies were quite similar, however. Today I've summoned the woman who was camping. The woman who was camping, Lana Hart. What happened next, detective? What was Mr. Edgeworth like when you saw him then?
Well, from what I saw, he looked pretty relaxed. Not like a murderer at all, really.
Detective! The court requires the facts, not your opinion. How many years have you been on the force? Facts only, detective. Hard, cold, objective facts.
Yes, sir.
Man, he's got a share of objections. Why didn't you think he was suspicious?
You should know. We have a deep, trusting relationship with the prosecutors.
Detective, the court isn't interested in your musings. Deep, trusting poppycock. I've never heard so many flippant comments from an active detective on the force. Ugh. Detective Gumshoe doesn't look so good. Continue, now! Did you find any clues on the body?
A single bullet was recovered from the body. He was shot through the heart, fatally.
Judge, here's the bullet. It didn't strike bones, so its shape is well preserved.
Very well. The court accepts this bullet into evidence.
Why is that?
Well, we found the murder weapon in the boat.
The murder weapon?
A pistol.
Detective Gumshoe, that is a vital piece of information. Please revise your testimony.
Right, sorry, Your Honor.
What about the pistol made it decisive evidence? You just see Mewful laugh as Edgeworth, which is not actually a laugh. It's a tut tut tut, but never mind.
There were fingerprints on the pistol found in the boat. They were clear prints from Mr. Edgeworth's right hand.
What?
Order, order! So, Mr. Edgeworth's fingerprints were found on the murder weapon? Yes, Your Honor.
Judge, this is the weapon in question.
Accept it into evidence.
Members of the court, we now have the pistol used in the murder and the bullet found in the body. Detective?
Yes, sir.
Was the bullet found in the body fired from this pistol?
Yes. The ballistic markings on the bullet match the pistol.
Hey, Nick. What does he mean by ballistic markings?
Shocking. To imagine someone here does not know something as basic as ballistic markings.
Nick is glaring at me.
Very well, I'll explain. Actually, Judge, you can do it.
Me?
Ballistic markings are like the fingerprints of a gun. The barrel leaves distinctive marks on each bullet it fires. You could examine these ballistic fingerprints to see which gun fired the shot. It's quite accurate.
Indeed. This leads to one inevitable conclusion. The bullet found in the victim's heart was without a doubt fired from this pistol. This pistol, which, as you may recall, was covered with the defendant's own fingerprints.
Order, order!
This is bad. This makes it look like Edgeworth did it. Well, Judge?
I'd say it's almost decisive, yes. Honestly, I could declare a verdict at this point. However...
You wish to hear the witness speak, no doubt. Very well. I am somewhat fatigued, so I will take a brief break. I will call my witness after the recess, which will last 10 minutes. Judge?
Yes?
What are you doing? A 10-minute recess, now!
But wait, I...
Just bang your flimsy gavel and get on with it, man!
Yes! The court will take a 10-minute recess.
Who's running this court anyway? Edgeworth, what's going on here? Your fingerprints are on the murder weapon! And that foggy photo makes one thing clear. The only one who could have shot that man was the person in the photo.
True.
Was that you in the boat?
Yes, it was me.
What?!
But you must believe me, I didn't shoot him.
Then who did?
I don't know.
You don't know? Weren't you right there?
I heard a gunshot from very close by. Then the other man fell from the boat. I can't say why, but I thought at the time that he'd shot himself.
You mean it was a suicide?
That's the only explanation I can come up with.
How am I going to convince anyone of that? Say, Maya.
Huh? What?
Any progress with Mia?
Oh. Sorry, it's no good. I know. I'm no good for anything, am I, Nick? If I can't call my sister, I might as well not be here, right?
No, of course not. I need you here. I can see you're always trying to help out. Even if you don't actually help, it's the thought that counts, right?
It's okay, Nick. You don't have to make me feel better. I don't know anything about trials or defense. What's more, I'm a spirit medium who can't even contact spirits.
Aw, everyone has their off days. I mean, I've just been getting lucky lately. But you never know when my luck's going to run out.
Really?
Whoa, right! Don't jinx this case any worse than it already is! It's bad for my heart. Oh, sorry! Whoops.
Court is back in session. Mr. Von Karmer, call your witness.
Yes. Will Miss Lotta Hart take the stand?
Let's not turn into... Who am I turning into when I do that voice? I don't know.
Lotta Hart, you are a research student at a university.
There I am.
Good. Begin by telling us what you saw the night of the incident. Don't add anything trivial or subjective. Understood?
Y'all need to learn some manners. Understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Everybody's got a cold in this courtroom. It's just going around, it's winter.
Very well, your testimony, please.
Do I just have an eternal cold and an eternal stuffy nose? I believe I do. I'm sorry, everyone.
It was Christmas Eve, just after midnight, I reckon. I was in my car. I heard this band come up from the lake. When I looked out the window, I saw two gents in a boat. Then there was another bang. There wasn't nary a thing on that lake but that boat.
Enough.
Huh?
Judge, she happened to take a photograph of the incident. This is the photo. Accept it as evidence.
Well, this is a surprise. This looks like the very moment of the murder. Order! I will remove you from the court if I do not have order immediately.
As the witness testified, she looked at the lake when she heard the shot. There were no other boats on the lake, so the man in the boat with the victim must have been the one who shot him. Yes, it was the defendant, Miles Edgeworth.
Order, order! I will have order.
Well, Judge.
The evidence is decisive. I have very little doubt about this case. Very well, this court finds the defendant.
Wait, Your Honor! I haven't cross-examined the witness yet.
A cross-examination? We have photographic proof. What question can there possibly be? This photo is worth 1,000 words, and they all read guilty. You lose. Or do you claim to have found a contradiction in her testimony? Very well. If you have to, you may cross-examine the witness. You will only flounder and ask meaningless questions. You will fail to find anything. And then I will have you held in contempt of court.
Nick, contempt?
Contempt of court, you know?
I guess I understand. Well, what are you going to do? Do you really think there was a contradiction with the facts in her testimony?
I think I noticed one little thing.
Wow, I'm impressed, Nick. I didn't notice anything. Right, let's take him on.
Yeah. I've got a bad feeling about this. I understand. I will cross-examine the witness.
Very well.
I pray for your sake this isn't a waste of time.
This is a colossal waste of time. Yeah. This is it. It's one thing. Just after midnight, you say. In other words, it was no longer Christmas Eve, but Christmas Day. Huh?
Well, yeah. Well, yes.
I know you want to find contradictions, but really?
I hope your next contradiction is a little more relevant to the trial. Witness, continue your testimony.
Could you clearly see the two men? Just look at the picture. Clear enough for you? Uh-oh. Wait a second. I wasn't asking you about the photo. I was asking if you saw the two men.
Yeah, well, of course. The witness has testified that she... The witness has testified that she saw them. There's also a photo. You'd best look elsewhere for your precious contradictions.
He jumped in quick. He's hiding something.
Were you watching the very moment the shot rang out?
Well, yeah, sure.
You're asking meaningless questions. Meaningless. Contradictions, Mr. Wright, not meaningless babble.
When Karma, I think I hate you. He's trying to keep me from talking to the witness. To what end?
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, sure as a country gal can be. That sounds pretty sure.
How come you're so sure?
Well, heck, I scanned the whole lake. Scanned the whole lake? It almost sounds like she was more interested in the lake than the boat. Miss Hart, you...
Mr. Wright, the witness has answered the question in full. No need for further questions. Objection sustained.
That's what I'm...
Sustained.
Yes, of course.
Oh, great. What am I supposed to do now?
There weren't any contradictions in there.
Sorry, Nick. If only my sister were here.
Leia's really taking this hard.
Well, look! This is what happens if you fail something. I'm trying to figure out what's going on. Your Honor, what do you think about the witness's statement?
I'm not sure I follow.
It clearly contradicts the... I thought...
You don't sound very convinced, Mr. Wright. Objection overruled.
I don't think that won me any points with the judge. This kind of meter is only in this game, where it gives you the strikes. The strikes don't exist at any point afterwards where it becomes a health bar. So you know. I'm gonna press everything.
Why were you camping there anyway?
I'm a research student at my university. I was taking pictures to use in my research.
What research? Sounds kind of suspicious.
Miss Hart, could you be more specific about your research? What does the witness's motive in camping by the lake have to do with this case? The answer is nothing. I object to this line of questioning. Objection sustained.
Wait, now I'm the one who says that.
Well then, say it already.
Objection sustained.
Thanks for nothing, Your Honor.
Enough. I think we've heard all we need to hear, Mr. Wright. It seems you are unable to find a contradiction in the testimony worth noting.
But Your Honor!
You keep your promise. Mr. Wright, I am afraid that I will have to penalize any further outbursts by holding you in contempt of court.
And if that happens, you'll have to leave the courtroom immediately. Understood?
Nick! Lada's testimony is fishy, Nick. Real fishy!
I know what you mean, but if I can't say anything, what can I do?
I believe we've covered the evidence sufficiently to make a decision.
Then pass your judgment.
Very well. Mr. Miles Edgeworth, please take the stand.
Hold it!
Who was that?
It was me!
Maya?
Is something wrong? Do you need to use the facilities?
No, I do not. Lada Hart! Your testimony stinks! It's unclear whether you're actually looking at the lake! It's highly doubtful that you actually saw Mr. Edgeworth! Tell us the truth! This is a matter of life or death! Lada! Did you really clearly see Mr. Edgeworth that night? Did you see him fire that pistol?
You will stand down. The court does not acknowledge the defense's outburst.
Answer me, Lauder. Lauder. What's the big idea, treating me like some kind of criminal? I saw him, I swear it. I saw Edgeworth.
Enough, Judge. Declare the defense in contempt of court.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry, but you were warned. Guard, escort Mr. Wright out of the courtroom. He is in contempt of court and must leave.
No.
Wait! I was the one who made the outburst, Your Honor. Nick is innocent.
Huh. What's the difference? All that remains is for the guilty verdict to be declared. Isn't that right, Mr. Felix Wright?
Wrong!
What?
Did you hear what Miss Hart just said? She said she clearly saw Mr. Edgeworth!
That was not in the testimony!
That changes her testimony and I have a right to cross-examine her again!
Order, order, order! Another three! There are many orders today at the court.
You're in contempt of court. It's too late for wild claims. Judge, sustain my objection.
I'm sorry, Mr. Van Kommer, but I cannot.
What?
Miss Lotterhart has just made a new testimony. The defense does have a right to cross-examine her again.
But he is in contempt of court.
No, I am. If you're going to arrest someone, arrest me.
Very well. Maya Fey, you will leave the courtroom immediately.
Nick, I did what I could. You have to do the rest. Good luck.
Maya.
I care not for this melodrama.
Listen well, Mr. Wright. I do not tolerate battering of my witnesses.
I'm running out of time. I'd better find a contradiction in here or else.
Mr. Wright, begin your cross-examination.
I saw it clear as day. The man in the boat was Mr. Edgeworth.
That's it? Uh-oh, I don't know if I can find anything in that.
Why you say?
Got you. Got you, Miss Hart. Finally.
What? You got what?
Look at this photograph.
The photo I took?
The very same. There's something I want you to see in this photo. It's quite clearly visible. The fog, Miss Hart.
So.
This picture was taken with professional, high-quality film, correct? Yet even it could not capture the faces of the men on the boat.
Yet you claim you saw Mr. Edgeworth.
How?
What? What?
Mr. Wright is a point.
That's why I told her not to say that in her testimony, please.
Yet now she has said it, Mr. Van Kommer.
How could you possibly see Mr. Edgeworth? Explain.
Miss Hart?
What?
Could you see the defendant that night?
Of course. I said I could and I meant I could.
Then please testify as to the circumstances of your sighting.
I did it. I finally found a hold of Inkarma's carefully vague testimony.
You're right. It was a cold night and the fog was thick as grits. So once I was finished setting up my camera, I got back in the car. Still, I brought my binoculars with me. When I heard that noise out on the lake, I looked out with my binoculars. See? No problem.
You used binoculars? Very well. You may begin your cross-examination, Mr. Wright.
This one had better be good.
Binoculars.
Yeah, binoculars.
Yesterday you mentioned that you were out looking for shooting stars, correct?
Well, yeah.
Wouldn't you need a telescope, not binoculars, for that? I've got doubts about your camera, too. Was that really to take pictures of meteor showers?
The camera is irrelevant to this case.
You can't see that for certain.
Mr. Wright, is the camera really relevant to the case? If you believe it is, you may continue with this line of questioning.
But know this. If you find nothing with this, there will be consequences.
Well, Mr. Wright, do you wish to press further about the camera?
This is make it or break it time.
The camera is of utmost importance, Your Honor.
It is perhaps the key to this entire case. Therefore, I will continue my line of questioning.
Wow. Maybe I went a little overboard there.
Very well. Miss Hart, you will testify to the court about the camera.
Yeah, I hear you. The camera was set up to take pictures of a meteor shower.
Miss Hart, what made you choose that lake to photograph meteors? You know, the fog gets thick on that lake. It's not very suited to stargazing.
Yeah, well, you see, I guess I wasn't thinking too straight.
Mr. Wright, I will not have you battering my witness because of her challenged intellect.
Now, wait a darn minute!
Continue your testimony. You were saying how it was that you saw Edgeworth? No unnecessary comments, please.
You were photographing shooting stars? That's a lie.
Says who?
I saw the camera you set up yesterday. It was pointed directly at the lake. You have to point a camera upwards to take photos of the stars, Miss Hart.
Mr. Wright, what are you driving at?
The witness was not at the lake to photograph shooting stars, Your Honor.
Well, and exactly what exactly was she photographing?
Your Honor, take a look at this. What was Miss Hart trying to photograph at the lake? Miss Hart, this is what you were trying to photograph.
What's this? A newspaper article?
Gordy?
Ah, the sighting at Gord Lake.
Well, Miss Hart?
I've never heard of no lake monster. You got proof or something?
Let's see if proof that I was down at the lake trying to photograph this Gordy.
I have it. Proof.
Intriguing. Very well, let's see it. No joking around this time, please. Here is proof that the witness was trying to photograph Gordy, the lake monster.
The proof, Miss Hart, is your own camera. Your camera was set up to take photos and responses to loud noises, correct? Thus, this photograph here, taken when a gun was fired on the lake. And here, this article about Gordy. According to this article, Gordy made a loud noise when it emerged. Well, you were trying to photograph Gordy, weren't you? That's why you had set your camera to respond to loud noises.
Order, order! I see. I too thought it was a little strange.
Yeah, sure. Well, Miss Hart?
You were camping there to try and take a photo of Gordy, weren't you?
Yeah. Not bad. Were all you lawyers that smart? So, smart boy, I was down there trying to photograph Gordy, you got me. So what? Huh? That don't change what I saw, does it?
Exactly. Exactly. Words. What you just used several precious minutes of our time to prove is nothing more than that the witness is an idiot who thinks monsters exist.
Hey!
But as she said, so what? It changes nothing.
Not true. You were hiding the whole thing about Gordy for some reason. I know it.
But what could it have been?
Whatever it is, I'm getting to the bottom of this.
Miss Hart, why did you hide the fact that you were searching for Gordy from the court? Please revise your testimony.
Right. Then I'll testify. It won't change nothing, though.
Something will change. It has to. And I'm going to spot it.
Actually, I'm not a research student at a university. I'm an investigative photographer.
Imagine what a scoop it'd be if I got a picture of that monster.
That's why I was camping out by the lake. But that's all I was hiding. When I heard the bang, I looked straight out of that lake. There wasn't much else to look at, so I just watched that boat the whole time. Then I saw a flash near one of the men's hands, and I heard another gunshot. I was looking right at the boat the whole time, crossed my heart, and hoped to fry.
Well, Mr. Wright, you may cross-examine the witness.
The witness's testimony is unchanged from before. Whether she is a research student or a photographer has no bearing on this case. There is no need to waste any more of our time with another pointless cross-examination. I claim the defense is right to cross-examine the witness, Your Honor. When Karma's up to something, I know it. He doesn't want me to cross-examine her because... why? Was there a contradiction?
Very well, you may begin the cross-examination. You seem sure of yourself. You must have something in mind.
That would be a first. Very funny.
You understand that this is your last chance at the cross-examination, Mr. Wright. If there is no problem with the testimony, it's time I will let the witness leave. I will also announce my verdict at that time, Mr. Wright. Understood?
Yes, Your Honor. Actually, I don't have to read this part. Exactly what sort of sound was it? Well, I never heard one before, so I can't say for sure, but it sounded like a gunshot. It was a lot sharper a sound than I would have expected. There wasn't much else to look at? Yep. I don't know. If she heard a bang and she thought Gordy was out there, I kind of doubt she'd waste any time looking in the boat. What? Wouldn't I just do now? What are you giving me that look for? Definitely suspicious. Maybe it's time for some evidence. Witness, continue. Hold your hush, puppies, pops. I'm getting there. Miss Hart, were you really looking at the boat? What's with you? Of course I was looking at it. It was the only thing out there. Any normal person be looking at it? I agree, any normal person would. But you are far from normal. What? Y'all wanna step over here and say that? You were camping at the lake to take a picture of Gordy. Think about it. What would you do if you heard a loud noise? You'd be scanning the lake for any sign of Gordy, that's what. You wouldn't get the boat a second thought. Order! Continue, Mr. Wright. You testified that you were watching the boat through binoculars. However, you wouldn't need binoculars to watch that boat. You needed them to search for Gordy, and that's exactly what you were doing. Well? Well, now that y'all mention it, I did sort of take my binoculars and kind of scan the lake a bit. I mean, Gordy might be out there and all.
Miss Hart! Are you saying you were not watching the boat, then?
Sorry, y'all. I wasn't fibbing, really. I was just... I thought, you know, I could be witness to a murder and all. I kind of got excited. I was sure I was watching that boat. Up until now.
This is totally uncalled for.
But hey! You got the photograph, you got proof!
Still, we cannot see who was shooting who in this.
Right. That's why I took this photo in.
Witness, that's enough. You've had a long day. Shut your pie hole.
Shut my what?
What was she going to say? She took the photo and what? Wait a second.
She enlarged that photo. Why won't Fun Karma let her show it? I've got a hunch. I bet that enlarged photo shows something bad for Fun Karma. This is my chance. If I'm wrong, though, it'll mean prison for Edgeworth. Or worse. What do I do? Miss Hart! Look at this photograph. You enlarged this photograph, did you not?
Yeah, I did.
Why has that enlargement not been presented to the court? Because it does not exist.
What are y'all talking about? You're the one who told me not to show it in court in the first place. You old fool.
What's the meaning of this, Mr. Von Karma? Miss Hart! Show the photo to the court. Show us the enlargement. The prosecution objects to the submission of this evidence. Objection denied. The witness will show the enlargement to the court.
Here it is.
We still can't see who was firing in this.
Well, that kind of swayback is only in Edgeworth. Isn't it? It's only in Edgeworth.
Like, seriously, that is pretty much one of his poses he does, isn't it? Except, turned around. It could be the defendant, or maybe it's not. Regardless, I'll accept this as evidence. Happy now, Mr. Wright?
There has to be something.
You asked for the enlargement, you got the enlargement. And little good it has done any of us. That's why I requested she not show it. I suppose this means that the cross-examination is over, obviously. Then I would like to close the cross-examination of Miss Lotta Hart. And none too soon. That was a flagrant waste of my time. Mr. Von Karma, do you have anything to add?
I stated everything I needed to when this trial began. Decisive evidence. A decisive witness. What else could possibly be required?
Nothing, of course. Then I believe it is time for me to declare my verdict. Wait, it's not supposed to go like this. There has to be a clue in this photograph somewhere. This is bad. Real bad. What do I do?
Your Honor! There is something decidedly strange with this enlargement.
What might that be? Mr. Wright, you will show the court what you mean. What about this photo? It's strange.
Okay, here goes nothing. I'll show the judge what's strange about this photo. Here, Your Honor.
The shooter? I'm not sure I understand. What about the shooter, Strange?
Look at the hand holding the pistol, Your Honor.
The hand?
That hand directly contradicts another piece of evidence. This man's left hand does what now? Let me show you. I'll show you the evidence that left hand contradicts. The evidence is clear. The man in this photograph is holding that pistol in his left hand. However, the prints on the murder weapon were from Edgeworth's right hand. Ergo, the man shooting the pistol in this photograph is not Mr. Edgeworth.
Now that everyone in the courtroom has quieted down, I would like to reconvene this court of law. Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor.
You have given us definitive proof today. We now know that it was not Mr. Edgeworth who fired the pistol that night. However, this leaves us with a rather large problem. If Mr. Edgeworth didn't do it, then who shot our victim?
Precisely. As we have seen, there were no other people on the lake that night. Who but the defendant could have shot the victim? There's only one explanation remaining. The man who shot the victim was none other than the victim himself.
Order, order! So, you are saying that the victim committed suicide?
Yes, Your Honor. I can think of no other explanation.
Indeed, that does seem to be the only remaining option.
I'm so very, very sorry, Mr. Wright. But suicide is out of the question. What?
An examination of the victim's wound reveals the distance at which he was shot.
The distance?
The victim was clearly shot from further than a meter away.
A meter? That's 3 feet!
There is no way it could have been suicide.
Order, order! Mr. Von Karma, are you sure of the accuracy of your data?
Of course. I had already considered the possibility of suicide, you see.
I see.
Very well, allow me to state my opinion.
Considering the situation, the shooter had to be the defendant, Mr. Edgeworth. However, the prints on the gun reveal that the shooter was not Mr. Edgeworth. This is a conundrum. Therefore, I would like to suspend proceedings for the trial for the day.
The court orders the defense and the prosecution to further investigate this matter. Understood?
Yes, Your Honor.
That is all. The court is adjourned.
That was a close one. Hey! Don't you have anything to say?
No. I have yet to be declared innocent, right?
Well, yeah, but... What happened out there on the lake, anyway? If he didn't commit suicide, then who? The shooter was about a meter away, too.
What?
What? Don't give me that look! I did not kill him! I was just kidding around. Look. I'm going to go check on Maya.
Oh.
Right.
What?
Tell her something for me.
What?
Tell her to watch what she says in court. That's all.
Yeah, I'm sure she'll be happy to hear you say that, Edgeworth. Jerk.
I requisitioned a transcript of Lada's entire testimony. I thought it might give me some ammunition for the trial tomorrow. Of course, she didn't see the shooter. So the part that stood out of her testimony was the bang she heard.